far we studied group 13 elements, that is boron group. In this video we are going to learn group 14 elements, that is carbon group. First one, catenation, allotropic form of carbon, carbon monoxide, the preparation, properties and uses of carbon monoxide. The same way in carbon dioxide, slick and tetrachloride, we are going to learn preparation, property and uses. Rest of the lesson in PPT.
Let us see the carbon family, that is group number 14 element. The first element is carbon. The native form of carbon is graphite, and large quantities of carbon we acquired from coal, crude oil, calcite, magnesite or the carbonate rocks. Next element is silicon. The silicon occurs from the silica. What is silica means? Sand and quartz crystal. Some of the silicate minerals and clay also are the important sources of silicon. Now we are going to see the catenation property. What is catenation means? It is an ability of an element to form a chain of atoms. So the catenation property have some conditions that are four condition, which satisfy that four condition, they have the property catenation. First condition is the valency of element is greater than or equal to 2. The second condition is ability to bond with itself. Third condition, the self bond must be a strong one. Fourth one, the kinetic inertness. What is kinetic inertness means? Having little or no ability to react, that is kinetic inertness. The kinetic inertness of catenation compound towards other molecules. So these four condition, which one satisfy that element have the property catenation. So here the carbon, the valency is 4, so the valency is greater than 2, so it has the catenation property. Next one, the carbon also form a bond itself, so and the bond also a strong one, and it has the property of kinetic inertness. So the carbon possesses the property catenation. Then it form a wide range of compound with itself and also the other elements like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur and halogens. This is the important 3-mark question, catenation. Now we are going to see the allotropes of carbon. What is allotrope means? They have the same physical state but different crystalline form. The first crystalline form of carbon is graphite. We are going to see the first crystalline form of carbon is graphite. This one is a most stable at normal temperature and pressure. It is soft and it conducts electricity. Why it is conducting electricity means? It has the pi electron, delocalized pi electron. The delocalized pi electron only conduct the electricity. Because of that delocalized pi electron, it conduct electricity. And the structure, now see the figure in the graphite. It is a flat two-dimensional sheet of carbon atom. Then each sheet is a hexagonal net, and each carbon, it is a sp2 hybridized carbon, and bond length between the carbon and the carbon is 1.41. it is nearer to the benzene, 1.40 armstrong between the carbon and the carbon atom, and each carbon valency is 4. It forms 3 sigma bonds with the neighbor carbon atom, and fourth electron is present in the unhybridized 3p orbital of the carbon, and it forms the pi bond. The pi electrons only delocalized, I already told you. This is the responsible for the electrical conductivity, and successive carbon sheets are held together by weak van der Waals force. It is mentioned in the diagram, and then distance between the each sheet is 3.40 armstrong degree. Don't confuse with that. The bond length is 1.41 armstrong degree, but each sheet between the each sheet length is 3.40 armstrong degree. Because of its soft nature, it is used as a lubricant either on its own or as a graphited oil. Next one is diamond. Diamond is the another allotrope of carbon. It is just opposite to the graphite allotrope, because graphite is a soft one, but diamond is a very hardest one. In graphite, the hybridization is sp2 hybridization, but here is sp3 hybridized, and the carbon valency here also 4, but it form 4 sigma bond. But in graphite there is 3 sigma bond, and bond length in graphite is 1.40 Armstrong degree, but here 1.54 Armstrong degree. In graphite there is a hexagonal arrangement, but here tetrahedral arrangement is exit, and there is no free electron in the diamond, but in graphite we have one free electron, so that free electron is responsible for the conductivity. Here there is no free electron, so it never conduct the electricity. Because of its hard nature, it is used for sharpening hard tools, cutting glasses, making bows and rock drilling. Next allotropy form of carbon is fullerene. It is a newly synthesized allotropy form of carbon. It has the discrete molecule. What is discrete molecule means? I mentioned in the below the diagram. Discrete molecules means it is a small groups of atom held together by the strong covalent bond inside the molecule and weak intermolecular forces between the molecules. These are called as discrete molecule. Fullerene having the discrete molecules of carbon 32, carbon 50, carbon 60, carbon 70 and carbon 76, etc. In this figure, the carbon 60 is mentioned. It is a saucer like ball like structure, so it is called as Buckminster fullerene or bucky balls. It is a fused ring structure. This contains 26 membered rings. You see that benzene like a ring has 20 and 12 5 membered rings, that is pentagon. It contains 12. The next one, the carbon hybridized of carbon is sp2 hybridized, and that carbon possesses 4 bond, but 3 bond form the sigma bond and 1 bond is delocalized pi bond. This is a delocalized so that it possesses the aromatic character, and the single bond between the carbon length is 1.44 Armstrong degree. The double bond length is 1.38 Armstrong degree. Now we are going to see another two allotropy form of carbon. One is carbon nanotube. This carbon nanotube, they have graphite like tubes with the fullerene ends. They have the stronger than steel and they conduct electricity. Because of this character, they are used in nanoscale electronics, catalysts, polymers and medicine. Next, another allotropy form of carbon is graphene. They have the single planar sheet. Unlike the graphite, they have only one planar sheet and sp2 hybridized like in the graphite, and they are densely packed. Each atom, the carbon atoms are densely packed, and it like a honeycomb crystal lattice. Carbon monoxide, it is one of the compound of carbon. First of all, preparation. When the carbon is reacted with the limited amount of oxygen, it gives carbon monoxide. And industrial scale means bulk preparation of carbon monoxide. When the carbon is reacted with the air, it gives carbon monoxide. Sometimes the air contains nitrogen, means along with the carbon monoxide we get nitrogen gas also. So combination, that is mixture of nitrogen and carbon monoxide, is called as producer gas. The producer gas, from the producer gas, how can we get the pure carbon monoxide? Means first of all, the producer gas is passed through the solution of carbon 1 chloride under pressure. It gives one compound, copper chloride, carbon monoxide and 2 moles of water. And at reduced pressure, this compound releases the pure carbon monoxide, so that we are getting pure carbon monoxide. We can prepare the pure carbon monoxide by another method, by warming the methanoic acid, that is formic acid, with the help of concentrated sulfuric acid. Here the carbon concentrated sulfuric acid is act as a dehydrating agent. What is dehydrating means? D means removal, hydrate means water. So removal of water. We are going to remove the water from methanoic acid. So remaining we are getting carbon monoxide with the help of concentrated sulfuric acid. Let's see the properties of carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a gas. It is a colorless, waterless and also a poisonous gas. This gas is slightly soluble in water. When the carbon monoxide is burned in air, it produces the carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide gives us a blue color flame. Then carbon monoxide, it is reacted with the chlorine in the presence of light or charcoal. It forms COCl2. The name of this compound is carbonyl chloride or phosgene. It is also a poisonous gas and it is used in the synthesis of isocyanate. And then another property is carbon monoxide acts as a strong reducing agent. That is, the compound nearer to it reduces that. For example, carbon monoxide when react with the ferric oxide, it remove the oxygen from ferric oxide and the carbon monoxide oxidize to carbon dioxide. Here, the carbon monoxide reduces the ferric oxide to iron. So it is act as reducing agent. Carbon monoxide here act as a reducing agent. Now the mixture of carbon monoxide and nitrogen is called as producer gas. The same way a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen is called as synthetic gas or syngas. When the synthetic gas or syngas undergo high temperature and pressure, it gives methanol. Methanol form is CH3OH. When carbon monoxide, the next one, when carbon monoxide reacted with the ethene and in presence of hydrogen gas produce propanol. See the reaction, CO plus C2H4, C2H4 is a ethene and plus hydrogen gives CH3, CH2, CHO. That is called as propanol. 3 carbon prop, single bond ane and then aldehyde means Al. So that it is called as propanol. Fissotrope synthesis, it is important question. We are going to synthesize the saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon with the help of carbon monoxide with the hydrogen. When the carbon monoxide is reacted with the hydrogen at high pressure which is less than 50 atmosphere and at 500 to 700 Kelvin in the presence of metal catalyst, the carbon monoxide is reacted with the hydrogen. That is, you see that first reaction, n mole of carbon monoxide plus 2n plus 1 mole of hydrogen, it gives CnH2n plus 2, that is unsaturated hydrocarbon, plus n mole of water. The second one, n mole of carbon monoxide plus 2n mole of hydrogen is reacted with each other, gives CnH2n, that is unsaturated hydrocarbon, and with the elimination of n mole of water. The next one, carbon monoxide, it forms the carbonyl complex. We already studied in our coordination compound. Here the it formed the carbonyl compound with the transition metal. Here the transition metal oxidation state is zero. For example, nickel tetracarbonyl, nickel is added with 4 carbon monoxide. Iron pentacarbonyl, that iron is added with 5 carbon monoxide. And chromium hexacarbonyl, here chromium is added with 6 carbon monoxide. Here in this carbonyl, all the metal having zero oxidation state. Next, the structure of carbon monoxide, it is a linear structure. Before that, the carbon valence electron is 4, oxygen valence electron is 6. Now see the first structure, there is a Roman letter 1. Around that carbon, we have one lone pair electron and 2 electron from the bonded one. In oxygen, there is 2 lone pair electron and then we get the 2 electron from the 2 bonded. So this is the first structure. And in this first structure, the lone pair of oxygen, it gives the electron to center double bond. So we get the first A structure. In this structure, carbon gaining electron from oxygen, so that carbon becomes negative character and oxygen lost electron, so that oxygen becomes positive character. In the first B, here the around the carbon, we have only one lone pair and then bonded also it gives one electron, that is one pair of electrons, so carbon becomes positive character. And oxygen, it has 6 electron as well as one more electron from the carbon, so that it possesses the negative character. So this is first B structure of carbon monoxide. Now we have the 2 canonical form of carbon monoxide. It is a resonance hybrid structure and bond length of carbon monoxide is 1.128 Armstrong degree. Uses of carbon monoxide. We already learned producer gas. Producer gas means it is a mixture of nitrogen and carbon monoxide. Water gas means it is a mixture of hydrogen and carbon monoxide. These two, water gas and producer gas, are important industrial fuel. So we can produce this industrial fuel with the help of carbon monoxide. The next one, carbon monoxide is a good reducing agent. It reduces many metal oxide to metal. So reduction means removal of oxygen. So it remove the oxygen from the metal oxide. So the metal oxide becomes a metal. The third one, it is an important ligand. We already learned the metal carbonyl in coordination compound. So we produce the metal carbonyl with the help of carbon monoxide. Then next, carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide we occur is a free state in nature, and also it obtained as a combined state in the air. And we get the carbon dioxide in the rock. It is a form in the form of calcium carbonate and magnesium carbonate. Next, preparation. First, industrial scale, that is bulk amount of carbon dioxide we are producing by burning coke in excess of air. First, the coke is reacted with the oxygen, gives carbon monoxide. Again, that carbon monoxide reacted with the excess of air gives carbon dioxide. The next one, calcination of lime. What is calcination means? That lime means calcium carbonate. Just we are going to give the give the heat in the absence of air. Then the calcium carbonate give the carbon dioxide on burning, and remaining we are getting calcium oxide. Then calcium carbonate, with the help of calcium carbonate, we can produce the carbon dioxide by another method, by action of dilute hydrochloric acid. Here the dilute hydrochloric acid react with the calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate, the carbonates are always given the carbon dioxide is the one of the product. So remaining thing we are getting calcium chloride along with the water. Properties of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is a colorless, non-flammable gas. It is heavier than air. Its critical temperature is 31 degrees Celsius. We have already learned in 11th standard. Under this critical temperature, when the pressure is increases, the gas automatically changes into liquid state. So it at 31 degrees Celsius, carbon dioxide readily liquefied. Then carbon dioxide is a very stable compound up to 3100 Kelvin. At 3100 Kelvin, only 76% of carbon dioxide is changed as a carbon monoxide and oxygen. So remaining things is stable as a carbon dioxide. And then above that high temperature, the carbon dioxide decomposes as carbon and oxygen. The next one, reducing behavior, that is carbon dioxide undergo reduction, but it oxidizes the nearer compound as a oxide. For example, carbon dioxide when reacted with the magnesium at high temperature, that is elevated temperature, the magnesium gain the oxygen and become as magnesium oxide. And carbon dioxide, it gives the oxygen and become as carbon. Then water gas equilibrium. Carbon dioxide reacted with the hydrogen gives carbon monoxide along with the water. This reaction is a equilibrium reaction, so it is called as water gas equilibrium. The next one, carbon dioxide along with the water gives carbonic acid, that is H2CO3. Again, that carbonic, it is a acid. So what is acid means? It gives H+. So H2CO3 gives H+, and HCO3-. It is also equilibrium with the carbonic acid. Structure of carbon dioxide. This is also a linear structure like carbon monoxide. There is only one sigma bond in the carbon monoxide, but here in carbon dioxide we have two double bond, one in one structure. In another structure we have single bond along with the triple bond. First of all, carbon valence electron is 4, we know very well. So around the carbon we have 4 bond. In oxygen, the valence electron is 6, so it possesses only 2 bond. So see the first structure, that around the carbon, around the oxygen, we have 6 electron along with one more bond, so that the oxygen, one of the oxygen possesses negative character. Then carbon, around the carbon we have 4 bond, so there is no charges in carbon. In another oxygen it possesses positive character because it has only one lone pair electron, so that it lost the electron, so it has the positive character. In the second structure, around the carbon we have 4 bond, so there is no charges in carbon. And also in oxygen, in both the oxygen it possesses only 2 lone pair electrons, so one more pair it get from the double bond, so that there is no charges in both the oxygen in the second structure. In third structure, around the carbon 4 bond is present, so no charges in carbon, but one of the oxygen possesses positive character because it loses the electron, because it has the in oxygen we need 6 electron, but it has only 2 electron, the 2 dot represent the 2 electron, so remaining thing it gives the bond, so that it positive character. Then another oxygen it possesses negative character. Around the oxygen we have already 6 electron, but one more electron from the bond, so that it gain the electron, so it has the negative character. So this is the canonical structure, two canonical form of carbon dioxide. Then uses of carbon dioxide, it used to produce a inert atmosphere. In the presence of carbon dioxide, given compound never react with the other elements, so that it produces the inert atmosphere. And also carbon dioxide, it is an important thing in photosynthesis. It is used as a fire extinguisher. Fire extinguisher means when the substance is carbon dioxide is produced on the substance, the substance never contact with the oxygen, so it never burn without the presence of oxygen. So it is used as a fire extinguisher, and also it is used as a propellant gas. And we are using cool drinks. In that cool drinks also the carbon dioxide is pressurized in that cool drink, so it is used as a carbonated beverages, and also it produces the foam. So these are all the uses of carbon dioxide. Next one, silicon tetrachloride. The silicon tetrachloride is produced with the help of silica. Silica means silicon dioxide, in the presence of coke, when the chlorine is passed over that at temperatures 1675 Kelvin, we produce silicon tetrachloride along with the carbon monoxide. And if we need the silicon tetrachloride in a large amount, with the help of silicon, when reacted with the hydrogen chloride gas above 600 Kelvin, we get the silicon tetrachloride in a large amount, that is called as commercial scale, along with the hydrogen. Properties of silicon tetrachloride. Silicon tetrachloride is a fuming liquid. In moist air, it hydrolyzes with water. It gives silicon tetrahydroxide. See the reaction. In silicon tetrachloride, I split into silicon and 4 chlorine. Water split into 4 moles of water split into 4 hydrogen and 4 hydroxy. The 4 hydrogen is reacted with the 4 Cl, gives 4 HCl. And then silicon with 4 OH gives silicon tetrahydroxide. The same way, the silicon tetrachloride hydrolysis with the moist ether, it produces linear perchlorosiloxane. The general formula is given here. Cl bond in square bracket, bracket, SiCl2ON and SiCl3. The N value vary from 1 to 6. So, in the moist ether, it hydrolyzes to give linear perchlorosiloxane. And alcoholism means just we are going to add alcohol. When the silicon tetrachloride is added with the alcohol, it gives sicylic ester. For example, silicon tetrachloride is added with the ethyl alcohol, it gives tetraethoxysilane. That C2H5OH is split into C2H5O and H, and then the silicon tetrachloride Si and 4Cl. The 4Cl is reacted with H, gives 4 moles of HCl, and then the silicon is reacted with 4C2H5O, gives tetraethoxysilane. Then ammonolysis, silicon tetrachloride is added with ammonia, it gives chlorosilazine. The formula is Cl3SiNHSiCl3. The temperature is 330 Kelvin, and in the presence of ether only it goes to react with the silicon tetrachloride. That ammonia goes to react with the silicon tetrachloride. And uses, the uses of silicon tetrachloride, it is used to produce the semiconducting material silicon, and also it is used to produce the starting material for the silicon gel, sisalic ester. The sisalic ester is a binder for ceramic material.